When a nation is righteous, when the citizen in the nation, when they were righteous, when they were living godly, such a nation will be great. Such a nation will move forward. Any nation where righteousness and godly living is lacking, shame and reproach is evident in that nation. Any nation where righteousness, godly living is absent, is lacking, what you receive from that nation is shame, is reproach all the time. As we are having it in our own country today, as we are experiencing reproach from the Committee of Nations, as we are experiencing shame from the Committee of Nations, if you are traveling out of this country and you are to be checked, if by the time they look into your passport very well and they see that you are Nigerian, they check you and check you and check you very well. In fact, at times I was at the airport, they said we should lose our belt. They even checked the belt because we were told that even some Nigerians, they put cocaine inside the belt and they tighten it. This is bringing reproach to us as a nation because we are not living righteously. Because we are not living a godly life, is bringing a shame and reproach to us from the Committee of Nations. And for us to build a great nation, to build a nation where peace, where justice reign, every one of us has our own responsibility to contribute in making our nation great. Building a great nation, it is possible to build a great nation through concerted efforts by the church. For us to build a great nation, the church of God need to put all our momentums together, put all our strategies together in building a great nation. May I say that this nation, the foundation of Nigeria, is laid by the church. Because the church contributed in building this nation. Before 1960, we had a lot of missionary schools. Before 1960s, and even up to today, we have missionary schools, we have hospitals built by missionaries. That the church was touching lives through the educational institution and through medical institutions, they were touching lives and nations were being built. But today, some of all these institutions are bastardized. Some of all these institutions, educational institutions and health, medical institutions were bastardized. Which means the church of God need to go back to the drawing board and rebuild this nation. Of what the Lord has used us to do 100 years ago, the church of God need to go back to it again. So, it is possible to build a great nation through the concerted efforts by the church of God. Through the active involvement of the church, a great and godly nation can be built. The church of God must be actively participate in the politics of Nigeria. Mark my word, policy and polity of Nigeria. The church of God must participate in the policy, in the policy making, in the decision making. The church of God must participate in it. The church of God was actively involved. Christians was actively involved in the policy, in making policy for the state. The children of God must do what? Must participate actively in it. Likewise, the church is a mirror to the nation to follow. She must set the pace for the states. The church of God is a mirror to the states, to the nation to follow. How does the church govern the church? I mean, in terms of leadership, the church of God must offer a quality leadership in the church so that the state will learn from the leadership lifestyle of the church. The church of God must offer quality education. We give glory to God today. Frontline denominations have universities. And some of these universities are living, if not all over the world, in Africa's sub-region. These universities are living. University owns by the mission. University owns by the church. They were leading in time of everything. They were leading. As we have not heard about any university owned by the church going on the industrial strike, and they were paid quality salaries. We have never heard when the university goes on strike. We have never heard when Covenant University goes on strike. We have never heard when Birmingham University goes on strike. These are universities owned by the church, and they never go on strike. And even their salary, the salary paid to their staffs, even double the one paid by the states. How is church running all this university? The state was land for it. So the church is a mirror to the states. The church is a mirror to the nation, for the nation to learn. And also, when the nation, when the leadership of the nation is going astray, the church must speak out. It is the responsibility of the church to speak out when the leadership they were going astray. The church must speak. Because even in the days of the Bible, we have Elijah always speak, always challenge Ahab. Always challenge the policy of the state. Elijah will stand up. Even Elijah, stand up, challenge. Even in the New Testament, John the Baptist saw when all of was going and openly, John the Baptist challenged Herod. So the church of God must speak out the truth to power. Let me say that. The church of God must speak the truth to power. Speak the truth to leadership. And this great nation can be achieved. The church is a solution to a dying nation like ours. A nation is dying. The church has the solution. From October 1, that every day I read newspaper, families are providing solutions. We are providing solutions to the Nigerian problem. We are providing solutions to the problem. How are we going to implement these solutions? It's left in the hands of our leader. Our nation is dying, but solution is in the hands of the church. How does the church have the solution? Because the church of God is a divine heritage on earth. The church of God represents Christ, represents God on earth. So because of this, the church of God has a solution in his hands. And we must not be in hiding. We have the solution. The church has the solution. The church of God must not be in hiding. The church of God must come out to give this solution to the states. Everyone must contribute his or her quotas in building a great nation. You are a teacher, contribute your quotas. You are medical practitioners, as students, parents, every one of us, pastors, all of us must contribute our quotas in building a great nation. You are parents and you are taking your children to medical center to write work. These are the leaders of tomorrow. What will they offer the society tomorrow? You take that child, you take him or her to miracle center, you look for machinery. In those days, miracle centers were in the bush where supervisor could not get. But before the supervisor get there, they've already finished all their foundation. But today, miracle centers are in the city. Even in the heart of the city, miracle centers are in the city. Where they help children, where they help secondary school students to write their wires. Even the supervisor, both the internal and external supervisor, they are collaborating to do this evil. How are we going to build a great nation? Somebody you help to write his final examination, and this person will become the leaders of tomorrow. What is he going to do? By the time you get to the top, you begin to embezzle the money of the state, because that is the way he or she was brought up. As a teacher, stand out! We're going to be a great nation when the police all the time collect bribe. We're going to be a great nation when the security operatives, when they get bribe all the time. How are we going to be a great nation? By the time you are traveling and you know that your document, your car particular, your car document is not complete, either road safety or whatever, they stop you on the way, I know this paper is not for what it has expired. Just put 200 naira there. By the time the officer opens it and make 200 naira there, you go. How is the state going to move forward when the security agent collects bribe at every checkpoint? The great nation cannot be like that. When the law enforcement agent becomes the law breaker, one way is only one way, but because you are special Nigerian, you take other way around. The great nation cannot be achieved. It is first come, first serve in the bank or any establishment, first come, first serve. But by the time it comes, it's not first come, first serve. The great nation cannot be built like that. People have been killed, have been on kill 1 hour, 2 hours, but it comes because it comes, it's a special Nigerian. And it jumped the kill. A great nation cannot be like that. A great nation cannot build when you waste time. There is nothing like African time. I could remember when it's African time, our parents, they keep to time. They keep to appointments. So there is nothing like African time. Because I grew up under my head parents. They came to appointments. When they say service start by 9 a.m., fourth bell would have been given 8:30. Am I telling lies? Fourth bell would have been given by 8:30. By the time the fourth bell jingle in the village, what will our parents do? They will have been on their way. They will use the 30 minutes to trek to church. And they will get there. There is nothing like African time. By the time we waste time, we cannot achieve a great mission. By the time we are waiting for somebody. I've represented church in different forums. We will be waiting for only one person. We can wait for only one person 2.5 hours. And we will be sitting there for 2 hours, 2.5 hours, only one person. Before that person comes, meeting will not start. A great nation cannot be built like that. I know this message is going on. That our leaders think must begin from them if you want to be the great nation. They are the one to think first. They said, stakeholders meetings, 9 a.m. All participants must sit by 8:30. Everybody sitting by 8:30. Mark my word, that meeting will not start until 11:30. It's what I've experienced. And we'll be waiting for one person. Until when that person comes. And that person will not even wait to the end of the meeting. By the time the person finishes reading his speech, what is he going to do? Take his name. A great nation cannot be like that. Our leaders, they are the one to first change you. He wants to take anything from this church today. Where is he going to start? From this church today. Are we going to start from the Sunday? We are going to start from the leadership. You say, hey, people are coming late to church. We leaders, pastor, deacons, what are we going to do? We come first. Then you will see change. Just commoners on the streets, we now arrest them. When we have a lot of criminals, you see this. The great nation. So the church has a solution. And every one of us must contribute our quotas. In the little corner you have, contribute your quotas. The role of the church in building a great nation. The church must teach and practice holiness. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. The Bible says, follow peace with all men and holiness. Without peace, no one will see God. The church of God, we must teach holiness. And we must practice holiness. Wherever you find yourself, practice holiness. Let them know that you are Christian. You live a holy life. The church of God, Christians, this is the time for us to live a holy life. The church has a mandate to pray for our leaders. Psalm 122, verse 6. Say, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. We are to pray for our leaders. We have that mandate to pray for leaders. Because their heart is in the hands of God. By the time they want to execute any policy, God may direct their hearts. And you may say, I don't even know why I did what I did. Because Because their hands is in the hand of who? The hand of God. The church is to always organize peaceful coexistence. We must live peacefully with our neighbors. Where you are working, let us learn to live peacefully. You did not come from the same region. You did not speak the same language. Inasmuch you are living together, learn to live peacefully with that person. And this is what is killing us in Nigeria today. By the time the person starts speaking your language, and you are in the position to employ, that person will not get that employment. You did not profess the same religion. Oh, you are not going to get the appointment. You cannot find a great nation like this. This is not the type of nation that our forefathers, our heroes have in mind, where we discriminate based on religion, based on background. Building a great nation, we should not discriminate based on our background, based on anything, we should not discriminate. So the church of God, believers, we must learn to live peacefully with everyone. The church must teach our members to be God-fearing and law-abiding. The love of God, let us be law-abiding. In everything we are doing, the law-abiding. Finally, believers must shine as lights in exemplary characters to others to emulate. We must shine in our exemplary characters for others to do it. For others to emulate us. To see a character, a good character in us and emulate us. I believe God is going to hand give unto us a great nation. We have peace. We have love. We have prosperity. Reigns in Jesus' name. Let's stand up and pray for Nigeria. Let us pray. God, we have over Nigeria to hand. Lord Almighty, let your peace reign in Nigeria. 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 Just pray prophetically. Let your peace reign in Nigeria. Let your peace reign in Nigeria. Let your peace reign. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Let peace reign in Nigeria.
Amen.
Let prosperity reign in Nigeria.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.